वेलकम बैक टू गूगल क्लास। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस विथ ट्रांसफर ऑफ प्रॉपर्टी एक्ट। ओके, चैप्टर इज टर्मिनेशन ऑफ लीज, सेक्शन 111। दिस सेक्शन 111 ऑफ द ट्रांसफर ऑफ प्रॉपर्टी एक्ट 1882 लेज डाउन द प्रोविजन अबाउट डिटरमिनेशन ऑफ लीज। The termination of lease is other name determination of lease. Okay, here determination of lease, section 111. This section contains 8 classes, 8 subclasses, 111 A, B, C, D, up to 8 classes as per the Bar Act. Okay, as per the Bar Act. I just wanted to explain Bar Act, then we'll discuss one by one further classes. Okay, section 111, determination of lease. A lease of immovable property determines 111A by a flux of the time limited, thereby 111B, where such time is limited conditionally on the happening of some event, by the happening of such event. 111 subclass C, where the interest of the lessor in the property terminates on or is power to dispose of the same extends only to the happening of any event by the happening of such event. Okay, section 111 subclause D, in case the interest of the lessee and lessor in the whole of the property become vested at the same time in one person in the same right. Section 111 subclause E, by express surrender, that is to say, in case the lessee yields up his interest under the lease to the lessor by mutual agreement between them. Section 111 subclause F, by implied surrender. Section 111 subclause G, by forfeiture, that is to say, number one, in case the lessee breaks an express condition which provides that on breach thereof the lessor may re-enter, or number two, in case of lessee renounces character as such by setting up title in the third person or by claiming title in himself, or number three, the lessee is adjudicated an insolvent and the lease provides that the lessor may re-enter on the happening of such event, and in any of these cases the lessor or his transferee gives notice in writing to the lessee of his intention to determine the lease. Section 111 subclause H, on the expiration of the notice to determine the lease or to quit or of intention to quit the property leased, duly given by one party to the other. Okay, that's all this termination of lease, all the classes explained as per the Bar Act. I'll give one illustration as per the section 111, and one illustration means 111 subclause F, by implied surrender. Based on this class, small illustrations. A lease accepts from its lessor a new lease of the property leased to take effect during the continuance of the existing lease. This is an implied surrender of the former lease, and such lease determines thereupon. Okay, go to another section, forfeiture of lease. This forfeiture of lease under section 111 sub clause G, 112, 114, 114A and 115. So this section explain forfeiture of lease. What is the meaning of forfeiture of lease? Okay, then one by one we'll discuss. Forfeiture means the deprivation of a person of his property as a penalty for some act or omission. Okay, a forfeiture clause in lease provide that on breach of certain covenants the lease shall be at an end and the lessor may re-enter. Equity relieved against forfeitures designed to secure the performance of some collateral act. Example, the payment of rent. When the court could give by way of compensation all that was required, a lessor cannot enforce a proviso for forfeiture and re-entry unless he serves on the lessee a notice specifying the breach and requiring its remedy and requiring compensation in money. Breach of a covenant not to deal with or dispose of the land leased formerly operated as a forfeiture, but now the tenant may apply to the court for relief also. Okay, the same section will give you the main important points. Waiver of forfeiture. Okay, waiver of forfeiture. Under the forfeiture heading, the main points, section 112, waiver of forfeiture. This section provides about waiver of forfeiture. Section 111 clause sub clause G is waived by acceptance of rent which has become due since the forfeiture, or by distress for such rent, or by any other act on the part of the lessor showing an intention to treat the lease as subsisting. And another point, relief against forfeiture for non-payment of rent. Section 114, relief against forfeiture for non-payment of rent, deals with under section 114, provides that where a lease of immovable property has been determined by forfeiture for non-payment of rent and the lessor sues to eject the lease. If at the hearing of the suit the lessee pays or tenders to lessor the rent in arrear together with interest thereon and his full cost of the suit, or gives such security as the court thinks sufficient for making such payment within 15 days, the court may, in lieu of making a decree for ejectment also, pass an order relieving the lessee against the forfeiture, and thereupon the lessee shall hold the property leased as if the forfeiture had not occurred. Okay. And another important point, relief against forfeiture in certain other cases, section 114 subclause A. Okay. It provides the relief against forfeiture in certain cases only. Here, the lessor has to serve on the lessee a notice in writing. Number one, specifying the particular breach of complaint of, and second, if the breach is capable of remedy, requiring the lessee to remedy the breach. That's all. And another points, section 115 of TP Act deals with effect of surrender and forfeiture on under lease. Effect of surrender and forfeiture on under leases. This section provides about effect of surrender and forfeiture on under leases, means the surrender express or implied of a lease of immovable property does not prejudice an under lease of the property or any part thereof previously granted by the lessee. On terms and conditions substantially the same as those of the original lease, but unless the surrender is made for the purpose of obtaining a new lease, the rent payable by and the contracts binding on the under the lessee, all such under lease expect where such forfeiture has been procured by the lessor in fraud of the under lessees, or relief against the forfeiture is granted under section 114. Okay, based on this section we'll discuss with case law also. Okay, I'll discuss this based on this case next class. Okay, because the case is entirely different from definitions, I just wanted to give elaborately, I just wanted to concentrate. Okay, okay students, the next video class we'll discuss about this section 111, 12, 14 and 15 of the case laws. Okay, two or three cases available. At least I will give you one cases and one example, then it is easy to understand. Okay, we'll meet you again students. Bye. Thank you.